Hey guys, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently we have 10 series that target your prelims and one series that is mains oriented. So this video is about the mains oriented series. So friends, let me tell you that what we do in this series, though for those students who are seeing this video for the first time, let me inform to them that we basically give 3 questions daily on this platform to you. And this mains answer writing series, we daily give you 3 questions, and out of these 3 questions, 2 questions are picked up from the current part and 1 question is picked up from the static part. So in this way you have to do the practice of 3 questions daily, because mains answer writing, you know, is a very important part of your preparation. If you do not do the practice, enough practice, then you will certainly suffer in the main stage. And this experience is common with the aspirants of the UPSC. So it is better to learn earlier than by mistake. It is better to learn by advice. So let's see what are the questions of today. That is 8th February. So we are seeing this question. So let's see what are the questions. The first question is about the US withdrawal from Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty has the potential to push world into yet another era of strategic uncertainty. Comment. So friends, you might have heard recently that recently US pulled out of the Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty that it had with the Russian government that was signed in 1987 in the Cold War era. So that US has the US under the Donald Trump administration has decided to withdraw from this treaty. So this has the potential to push world into yet another era of strategic uncertainty, and you have to comment on this statement. So you have to tell your understanding about this statement. So let's move on to the second question. What is the second question of today? So the second question is, unless the institutions of a democratic country work under the legislative supervision, the flaws in their working and credibility are bound to resurface time and again. Discuss in the context of India's democratic polity. So friends, you have to discuss this statement. So institutions of democratic country, unless they are work under legislative supervision, the flaws in their working is bound to resurface time and again. So you have to, it is a question that is picked up from the current topic, so I will not explain further on it. You have to apply your own mind, because you must be prepared to face such unpredictable statements in the UPSC, because UPSC feels unknown and yet not identified pleasure in disturbing the students in the exam hall. So you must be prepared, and you must think that in which context this statement is, and you have to write 250 words on it, and the maximum marks are 15. So next question is about the static part. As I have told you that we daily give you 3 questions, out of which 2 questions are picked up from the current part and 1 question is from static part, that is told to you 1 day in advance. So in this week we are covering the Indian society, so that's why the question, static question, is from the Indian society. So the question is, to what extent and in which manner did British colonialism impacted Indian society? So you have to tell that to what extent and in which manner did the British colonialism impacted Indian society. So the word limit is 250 and the maximum marks allotted are 15. So friends, these are the questions of today, that is 8th February. So you have to write about them. So let me tell you to those students who have not seen these videos earlier, that what is this initiative is all about. So friends, it is an initiative that daily covers 3 questions, as I have told you, 2 from current part and 1 from static part, and the questions are of UPSC mains level that are given to you, and you have to write the answers of these questions, and you have to send to us on our WhatsApp number, that is 8968426481. So this is our WhatsApp number. You have to write the answers of these questions and you have to send to us for evaluation. So friends, the major issues of evaluation, because there are a lot of platforms that provide you questions, but the evaluation is not done there, or the evaluation is done by the students themselves who are in the preparation stage, not more than 6 months, or for that matter 1 year. So it is difficult to get an expert opinion from them, because they are also in preparation stage and they do not know the mindset of the examiner or the UPSC examiner. So in that sense you must get an expert opinion on your answers, so that you can get an idea about that, what are your plus points, what are your negative points, where are you lacking, and where you kind of you have an edge. So these things must be told to you in a bold manner, so that is not done on other platforms. So we are sorting out this issue of yours, that because we will evaluate your answers and we will help you to improve your answer writing skills. So friends, also relevant material is will be provided to you relating to each question, because sometimes certain students say that, sir, we don't have the idea of the question in the topic, so topic in the question. So friends, in that case we will also provide you reference material so that you can read about the topic and you can prepare about you can prepare about your own viewpoint about that topic. So in this way you will get reference material, and that reference material will be given to you on the next day of the questions. For example, for the today's question you will get the reference material tomorrow. So in this way this initiative works, friends. As we are putting in a lot of effort, so certainly it will entail some cost if you want to get your answers evaluated. So there is a fee structure for the initiative. So fee structure is before you. We have kept it as minimum as possible, so it is ₹1,000 per month. And in case you want to evaluate your answers, and in case you want to join us for more than a month, then you can join for February to April. That is for this it is 2700, that is at a discount of ₹300 for the package. But in case you join for retrospectively for January month, because we have started this initiative in January month itself, so obviously January month questions are important for you people to revise them. It is important for you people if you have to write the mains this year. So obviously you can join us retrospectively. In that case you will get also the reference material of January month, as well as you will be eligible to write the questions of January month. So the 4 months package is available to you in ₹3,200, that is at a discount of ₹800. So that is, you can get the 4 month package in ₹3,200. But in case, for example, you want to join only for 2 months, say for example February or March, then this initiative is available to you in ₹1,800, that is at a discount of ₹200 for the package. So friends, if you want to subscribe to this initiative, you can do WhatsApp us. You can do WhatsApp at this number, that is 8968426481. So this is our number. You can also mail us. We will provide the mail in the comment box, in the description box. So you can mail us also, and in this way you can join to our initiative. And friends, let me tell you that those students, ideal students who say that we should not charge, please stay away from messaging us. It is my humble request to all those people that UPSC needs practical persons. UPSC is all about the practicality of a person. If you are living in an ideal world, that thing is not demanded by UPSC, because ideal world is never gonna be there. So obviously we are putting in lab efforts. So obviously we in that case are entitled to charge you the minimum, the minimum amount. So in this case, let me tell you that you are also preparing for a social status, or for that matter for salaries and perks. In case you become an IAS officer, and you will also be not renouncing your salary or for that matter perks or status for the national service. Obviously you will be getting them. In case you will renounce them, then certainly do tell us. We will also renounce our claims. So we be practical here, be very practical, be very realistic. We don't want fake persons, and also we are not fake persons, so we don't also like fake persons. So that's why we are clear. We tell you in a bold manner our policies and our initiatives and our approach. So this is about, friends, today's video. If you liked the video, if you liked the questions, if you liked our practicality, if you liked our realistic nature, then do like this video and please do share it with your friends. And also, friends, also please subscribe to our channel if you want to continue with us. And also do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the notifications relating to UPSC CSE 2019 that we will do on our YouTube channel. So this is all about today's video, friends. Have a nice day. Thank you. Thank you very much.